Honestly, I just don't know where to fucking begin. I don't know where to begin. I'm to a point where I'm just so tired of fucking dumb shit. You ever get to that point where, you know, shit just gets so dumb that you don't even want to talk about it? Don't even want to think about it. You're just like, fuck it. Now, guys, there's been a lot of shit going on in the world here today and the past days. All the cancel shit and you noticed on the channel, I haven't really been talking about it. I'm just to a point where on the channel, I'm just like, fuck the shit. I've avoided talking about it. I've avoided talking about, you know, the girl from The Mandalorian getting fired. I've avoided talking about the Dr. Seuss shit. I've avoided it. I just stayed away from it because I just, you ever have a friend or an acquaintance or somebody you ever talk to about some problem, something that's so obvious that, you know, after you talk about it, you're saying to yourself, why the fuck am I even talking about this? This dumb fuck should already know this stupid shit that we're talking about. So I've avoided talking about the bullshit. You get to a point where you're just like, fuck the bullshit. You do not want to talk about the fucking bullshit. But you know, no matter how far you try to separate yourself from bullshit, bullshit always manages to sneak right back into your life. Now, you know, in the old Popeye cartoons, Popeye used to get to a point where he would say, I've had enough, I can't stand it, and I can't stand no more. And I've gotten to the point where I'm just tired of the bullshit to where I feel like I needed to vent about the shit. Now, a good friend of mine on Facebook and a subscriber to the channel sent me a couple of articles. And you know, these articles were something that I hadn't read before. I stayed away from it. I didn't really want to, you know, the cancel shit going on. And you know, I've just, you know, distanced myself from it. I really didn't want to be a part of the bullshit. But he sent me an article. And I got it on my phone here. Let's see. He sent me quite a few things, so I have to scroll to find it. I think he sent me two articles on this particular subject. But the first one is talking about New Legacy, New Lola, Why Space Jam Wanted to Do Better by One Tune. And they're talking about Lola Bunny. And they're talking about how apparently, for all of us that didn't know, she was really sexualized and objectified in Space Jam. And I'm just reading this shit and I'm just like, why the fuck do people devote all this time to shit that does not amount to or is important to any part of our existence? Obviously, there's too much free time in the world. Let's see. We have the pandemic. We have world hunger. We have people going to bed, starving in our country alone. We have disease running rampant. We have environmental issues. We have guns and murder. And we have racial prejudices. We have all this fucking shit going on in the goddamn world. And we want to sit and talk about fucking Lola Bunny's fucking basketball shorts. Who the fuck does that? Who the fuck gives a shit about what a fucking cartoon rabbit wears? God damn. And guys, it makes me mad because I am sitting here talking about pure and utter bullshit. I mean, if you've got to raise hell on an issue like this, then obviously you don't give a shit about the rest of the world. If this is your maintaining factor to confront and try to deal with, you don't give a shit about any other goddamn problems in this fucking fucked up world we live in. Fucking shit. We're not even talking about a goddamn real person. We're talking about a fucking cartoon. Objectifying a fucking rodent. Any goddamn way, man. I just can't do it. I just can't fucking live in this world too much longer, man. I don't know what the fuck's going on. I just don't know what's happening in the world anymore. What the fuck? I mean, we went through that time where everybody was fucking offended by every goddamn thing. And now it's turned into media franchises. And we're fucking worried about somebody getting a stiffy off a fucking cartoon rabbit. Where's the article that everybody, I just can't do it, man. I just can't fucking do it. I'm sorry for all the shouting and yelling, guys, but you know, if you want to focus on dumb fucking stupid shit like this, then you get a dumb fucking reaction like mine, man. There's so much more in this fucked up world that we live in to turn our attention to. So much more. Why don't we talk about the people and the hardships that people have? Why don't we talk about important shit? But we want to talk about a fucking rabbit. Wow. And it's almost, you know, if it wasn't so ridiculous, it would be funny. Anyway, this fucking article. When Space Jam, A New Legacy director Malcolm D. Lee, oh fucking hell. And I said this to a good friend on the internet last night. Did anybody fucking ask for a Space Jam sequel? Who asked for that shit? Who needed that shit? Anyway. Lola Bunny was very sexualized, like Betty Boop mixed with Jessica Rabbit. He says of the cartoon, or he says of the character who is called Hot by Tweety of all tunes, Lola was not politically correct. You know what? Fuck politically correct. Fuck PC. I'm so fucking tired of hearing about PC. You know, I'm all for treating people correctly. I'm all for being respectful towards your fellow man. But don't fucking sit and preach to me about a fucking cartoon character, you fucking idiots. Lola was so sexualized. I mean, who is fucking even thinking about that shit? So I guess, you know, you can't say a woman is beautiful. You can't say a woman is sexy. You can't say a woman is hot. I mean, what's the big deal? What are people so fucking afraid of? And you know, this reminds me. I was watching I think it was The View. I was watching a clip from The View. Maybe it was The News. I'm not for sure. But there was a lady on there, and they were talking about this whole Chris Cuomo thing and all the people he's come on to, all the women. And for the record, guys, I honestly believe that the guy should resign. But anyway, she was talking about how women have to suffer and endure so much, all because she got all upset because this guy came into the office where she worked at, a coworker. She looked really nice, and he said, "You look nice today." And she got all pissed off. Why is he even looking at me? Why is he even noticing how I look? What's it to him how I look? You know, I'm just like, what the fuck? What the fuck? He should have just came in and said, "Bitch, you ugly." Would that have been better? "Bitch, you look like shit today." I mean, my God, when did we just lose common courtesy? If I see a woman out there and I think she's nice looking, is it a big sin to say, "You look nice today"? There must be some kind of underlying problem in the male if he says you look nice. Apparently he's got ulterior motives. He wants to get in those panties because he said you look nice today. And I guess, you know, if a woman says to a guy, "He's very handsome. You look handsome. You look nice." Am I supposed to cry wolf? Oh my God, she's looking at my dick. She said I look nice. fucking shit, man. We act like a whole fucking society of fucking crybabies. Fucking goddamn shit, man. It's just so fucking ridiculous. And I mean, if you want to judge Lola Bunny's attire, this sounds so fucking ridiculous. But I mean, it's like, so what's next? What's fucking next? Is Superman not going to be able to fly because we're worried about kids jumping off a goddamn building? Are we going to have to say, Superman, you need to start walking now? Are we going to have to censor the Flash and not have him running out in front of cars because somebody might run out in front of cars and die? I mean, when does it end? And I can tell you one fucking thing. It's probably not going to get any goddamn better before it gets... it's just going to get worse. This shit's ridiculous. I mean, you know, I can remember way back when going to the movie theater and watching Demolition Man and thinking it was a totally ridiculous future. Oh, you got fined for cursing. Oh, we're having sex in just a big prophylactic body shield. Oh, you can't cuss. Oh, there's only, no, you have to eat this. I thought that premise was utterly ridiculous in terms of how the future was. But now I see Demolition Man's future very possible. That's where we're headed. We're headed. I mean, we're losing everything. I mean, some of my biggest thrills was coming home in the evening watching Johnny Quest, watching the Transformers, which, you know, even the Transformers, I'm sure they'll probably get away from or using guns. They'll probably just give middle fingers to each other. Where does this fucking shit end? And the last straw for me was this Space Jam shit. Who gives a fucking flip what fucking color Lola Bunny's panties are? Although that's not one of the things brought up, I'm just saying. But furthermore, and I'm just skipping over this article. This is a kid's movie. Why is she in a crop top? It just felt unnecessary. But at the same time, there was a long history of that in cartoons. In preparing for the LeBron James-led New Legacy, which graces the latest EW cover, Entertainment Weekly, Lee set out to make a more fully realized Lola, aided by the leeway he has had since she was created specifically for Space Jam and didn't have the same extensive history as the rest of the toons. This is 2021. It's important to reflect the authenticity of strong, capable female characters, says Lee. She probably has the most human characteristics of the toons. She doesn't have a thing like a carrot or a lisp or a stutter. So, we reworked a lot of things, not only her look, like making sure she had an appropriate length on her shorts and was feminine without being objectified, but gave her a real voice. For us, it was, let's ground her athletic prowess, her leadership skills, and make her as full a character as the others. It just amazes me that there's actually people out there trying to figure out how to fucking make a cartoon politically correct. A fucking cartoon. And if we want to go by that standard, well, why does Bugs Bunny have a lisp? Why don't we get rid of Elmer Fudd's stutter? Why don't we change Daffy Duck's voice so that he's more PC? Why don't we just change all the fucking characters to where they're politically correct and we don't have to worry about nobody being offended? Why are we just focusing on Lola? Why is it the female character? Let's change all the motherfuckers. Fucking dumb fucks. God damn. We don't want her objectified. So it's okay that the male characters are representations of themselves. But the female character, we've got to change the female character. She's been mistreated and objectified. And you know, fuck Space Jam 2. The way I feel, fuck that movie. I don't want to see a fucking Space Jam 2. I don't give a shit about Space Jam. I don't give a fuck about your PC correct bullshit. Fuck you and that movie. Fucking shit, man. The most fucking ridiculous shit I have ever heard in my entire life. like a little girl sitting out in the audience. Oh, mother, I look up so much to that Lola. Look, mother, her shorts are longer now. Look, mom, her boobs have been minimalized. They barely even show. God damn, man. Fucking hell. What the fuck is going on? We're big enough to take a few punches. No, we're not even big enough to take an insult. Fucking shit, man. Just fucking shit. I'm just so tired of the stupidity. So tired of it. I mean, you know, I rant on movies. And, you know, a lot of times a rant is just over the top and you're having a little bit of fun with the film. And you're expressing it kind of a little colorfully. But shit like this, you're fucking with, you know, my history. I went and saw Looney Tunes. You know, I saw Looney Tunes as they were. And, you know, even today, there's certain Looney Tunes that they don't even show anymore. And, you know, it's all about political correctness and not offending people and all this kind of shit. And I'm just so tired of this fucking shit, man. Just so tired of it. I mean, we're just raising everybody to be fucking pussy weights, man. Oh, did I say pussy? Did I say pussy? We wanted to meet her with the Amazons. Trying to find greener pastures for herself, says Lee, revealing that Lola's reintroduction is set in the world of Wonder Woman, which is just one part of the new film's use of the WB film catalog. As she says in the movie, there's more to her than just being a toon. Shit. Yeah, and you got nerve to bring up Wonder Woman in this article, who in the last film virtually raped a guy that had no control over his body, had sex with him, didn't want him to ever have his life back. Fuck that movie. That's a great example you use there, but that's, of course, okay, because it's a woman. Fuck Space Jam, man. And then, you know, icing on the cake, guys, he sent me another article, and in this one, it covers Pepe Le Pew. Pepe Le Pew axed, taking out of Space Jam sequel, even before controversy. Now, of course, if you're not familiar with Pepe Le Pew, he's the skunk who, you know, in all his cartoons, he forces himself on this cartoon cat that he thinks is a skunk. He's a French-based character, French accent, and he's a lover. He forces himself on the girl and just kisses her. And, of course, you know, you can see where I'm going with this, right? I mean, we've got a character. Goddamn phone. I get the phone close to my computer and I start hearing static. But anyway, he forces himself on girls. When he sees this cat, he just runs, grabs her, starts kissing her and all this. So you can see where, you know, this is headed. You can see why Pepe Le Pew is going to be a problem, right? Despite the fact that, you know, he's just a cartoon character and none of this shit really even matters, you know. I guess we got to force feed every goddamn person on this fucking earth. It's not right to go force yourself on a woman's son. It's not right to go kiss a woman against her will. Of course, we need to be, you know, we need to know that from a cartoon to know that it's wrong to actually do that, right? Anyway. Pepe Le Pew's problematic behavior appears to be something Warner Brothers was well aware of before he was called out anew, because he reportedly doesn't make a single appearance in the new Space Jam, which I think they should call Space Shit, because it's a bunch of shit. A new Deadline report explains that the Looney Tune character actually had a scene written into the movie early on in the production when director Terrence Nance was still at the helm. Apparently, there was a Casablanca-like scene in which Pepe played a bartender and tried kissing the arm of a human character portrayed by actress Gracie Santo. Santo pulls back and slaps Pepe silly, and LeBron James actually gave him a pep talk of sorts, letting him know it wasn't cool to get grabby without consent. This is so fucking ridiculous, Ben. You're giving a fucking pep talk to a fucking animated skunk. Yeah, how smart does that fucking sound? LeBron, you should be giving fucking pep talks to your fucking team. They're the ones that people have to worry about, not this fucking skunk. This shit is so fucking ridiculous. I just can't believe I'm sitting here explaining the merits of talking and giving a pep talk to a fucking non-existent animated skunk about fucking grabbing people. God damn, man. God damn. Listen to this shit, guys. This is just unbelievable. The outlet also says Pepe referenced his longtime muse, Penelope Pussycat. That's the cat that he always tried to chase and kiss in the old cartoons. The outlet also says Pepe referenced his longtime muse, Penelope Pussycat, and said she'd taking out a restraining order against him. At least that's what was going to be in the flick before it was scrapped when Malcolm D. Lee took over as director. Yeah, we have Pepe explaining that, yeah, I can get a little bit grabby, and she got a restraining order against me. Yeah, I'm sure. Yeah, kids really need that lesson in this fucking movie. Yeah. Word is, the Pepe scene was axed entirely in the final cut of the film, which is set to debut this summer. And according to folks who've seen a screening of the movie per Deadline, they say there's no trace of Pepe anywhere in what people will see on HBO Max. So we can have a film, you know, we can have films on HBO where people are, you know, getting devoured by monsters, getting cut in half, violent films. But we're worried about a animated skunk kissing a cat. Yeah, because little girls are just going to see that, and little boys are going to just, you know, see that and think that they've been given permission to have their way with a little girl. Because that's what happened when we all watched Pepe Le Pew as little kids. We just were overcome with, I want to go force myself on a little girl. And that's what happened, you know, when we watched Bugs Bunny and Elmer Fudd. We just wanted to go run and pick up a gun. And I'm sure you all are aware of the whole HBO Max show with Looney Tunes where Elmer Fudd doesn't have a gun anymore. And I'm just like, fuck, man. Of course, all fucking gun violence is related to Elmer fucking Fudd hunting Bugs Bunny. Yeah, that's how many murderers or mass shooters have been interviewed today. And they say, I wouldn't have picked up that fucking gun if it wasn't for Elmer Fudd. Fucking dumb fox. God damn. God, the stupidity of humankind. Are we so fucking weak? Are we so fucking weak of mind that we can't be trusted to have good intentions of our own? Oh boy. Remember, Pepe is in the original and has a few moments of screen time where he stinks up the place to score points and even jumps on an old woman to kiss her. Now, whether this decision to lose Pepe altogether was made because of the New York Times controversy in which a writer said the skunk normalized rape culture. A skunk normalizes rape culture. I just can't believe that people actually sit and write these articles with a straight face, man. I would fucking break 15 goddamn pencils writing this shit. I mean, I'm pretty goddamn sure that there haven't been rapists in court defending what they did by saying Pepe Le Pew made them do it. It would seem the two things are unrelated, or so says Dateline. It's unclear why exactly he got nixed. Is it really unclear? Is it really fucking unclear? We get a whole fucking movie where Wonder Woman rapes a guy against his will, no doubt. And then we're worried about Pepe Le Pew. Must be because he's a male character, I guess. Nonetheless, Santos reps tell Deadline she was disappointed. This is the actress that he actually kissed at the beginning of the scene. This is the actress talking about the scene that was cut. Nonetheless, Santos reps tail deadline, she was disappointed to learn the scene wouldn't air because she, as a victim of sexual harassment, was proud to put Pepe in his place and now wouldn't be able to let little girls know that this behavior isn't okay on the bigger stage. Well, I mean, that's one way of saying it. But yeah, guys, I'm sure any kid could look at Pepe Le Pew and know that, you know, him forcing himself on the girl, they're going to know that's not how you should do things. I think humanity is being dumbed down. We're dumbed down to a fucking point now where we just, you know, society is gearing us towards pure stupidity. You know, all the great accomplishments that we've made as humans, all the strides forward, all the technology. And you mean to tell me that we can't sit down and watch an animated cartoon objectively and just, you know, we're so dumb, we're just going to run out and do the exact same thing that the cartoon does. Now, when the Roadrunner chases Wile E. Coyote and Wile E. Coyote jumps off a cliff, are we going to have to stop airing those because kids are so gullible that they're going to fucking jump off a cliff too? When does mental disease come into play? Because there's something mentally wrong if anything in a fucking goddamn cartoon is teaching you how to live in real world. And, you know, furthermore, and to add insult to injury, this article was, there was another one written where it says, daughter of Pepe Le Pew creator says she understands characters' exclusion from the new Space Jam. And I mean, fuck, I understand it. Do I agree with it? No, but I understand it. So I'm just to a point, boys and girls, where I'm just so tired of this fucking shit. I'm just so tired of it. You know, I'm a lover of Star Trek, the original series. And oftentimes I wonder, you know, when will that get edited? When will there be things in that are not PC? When will, you know, things that happen in that show be considered outrageous and detrimental to society and instrumental in keeping a woman down? You know, if we really want to lift women up, why don't we present the world as it is, rise above it, learn from it, and then just do what's right? Because when you cancel something, it does not mean that it's not known, that people are not aware of it. It just means that we're too big a pussies to put faith in humanity to move forward above these things. We don't need goddamn people making decisions for us. Let us make our own fucking decisions. Let's have faith that humanity can do the right thing. And, you know, in some instances, you know, there are certain situations where, you know, perhaps some things do need to be toned down or canceled. But animated cartoons, especially in the articles that I read over today, I don't get it, guys. I just really don't. You know, just because you cancel something doesn't mean that, you know, it's still not out there, because it is. And, you know, there were things in the original Looney Tunes that could be construed as racist. There were black characters in those cartoons that I watched as a kid with the big lips and, you know, just the totally black faces. And I watched those. And I think the reason and honestly, you know, I had good things going for me. I had a parent who explained to me about what I was watching. And then at the same time, you were looking at a kid that just, I didn't see any of that stuff. I mean, I know that it's there now, but at the time I didn't see any of that. It didn't matter to me. It didn't affect me in any sort of negative way. I laughed, and, you know, I'm not saying that, you know, in some of the depictions of black people in those animated cartoons, it's totally over the top. And I can't agree that some of it is racist. But at the same time, I just feel like, you know, as we've moved forward, we've accomplished more moving forward than what we've left behind. And I feel like we should not fear the past. We should not erase the past. We should put it in its proper perspective. We should understand why it happened. We should understand what motivated it to happen. We should understand the framework of the thought of the country at the time when this happened. Because we can't learn from the past if we act like that past never existed. Canceling it is not the way to move forward. Put it in its proper perspective. Put it in a museum. Just, you know, we need to learn from our past. We need to know, you know, every country's got horrors of the past. We need to learn from those horrors. We need to see those horrors. We need to understand those horrors, and we need to move forward. Prime example, you know, there's a scene in the original Star Trek where Abraham Lincoln, or an alien that looks like Abraham Lincoln, or a projection of something of Abraham Lincoln, comes to the Enterprise. He sees Lieutenant Uhura, which is a black lady, and he says, "What a charming negress." And the alien looks around at, you know, at some of the reaction of the crew, just the look on their faces, and he goes, "I'm sorry, I didn't mean to offend you." And she says one of the most remarkable things ever said. She says, the black lady, as being called this, she says, "It's okay. In my time, we've learned not to fear words." So I think using that shining example from this great television show that we need to learn from our past, not fear the past, not try to hide it. We need to learn from it, move forward, and be fucking better from it. But unfortunately, that's not a mindset that is very popular in today's world. Today's world is filled with fear. It's filled with weakness. And it's filled with a culture that believes that hiding these things or canceling these things is the way to handle it. And for me to have a grown man sit and say that Lola Bunny in Space Jam was sexually objectified and detrimental to all women, that is just the most fucking ridiculous fucking thing I have ever fucking heard in my entire life. And I think women are stronger than that. I have faith in women. Women are strong. One of the strongest women I've ever known was my grandmother, my mom, other women out there that are trailblazing in the world today. Despite all that black people have been through in this country, in our history, you know, sometimes it doesn't seem like we're moving forward, but we are moving forward, and things have gotten better. And that's not saying that things are perfect, but they have gotten better. And I think as a civilization, we're going to have to learn to get better and to, you know, face our problems head on, learn from them, and move forward. In closing, I'll just say, fuck the bullshit. Fuck the bullshit.